Now let's understand how Excel has decided what should be red, yellow and green and what should be filled in here. In the first part, it was very explicit. You specified exactly what you wanted to see and the colors were done. When it came to these labels, the color matrix and the icons, Excel has to do some guesswork. So if I just highlight these, go to conditional formatting, and I look at manage rules, what you'll see, I'm going to go to the data bars one and say edit. This is how Excel has decided what these should look like. So you'll see the format style is do you want a data bar, an icon set, etc. Notice you can decide whether you want to show the bar only. So do you want to see these numbers or not? If I say show bar only, you'll see you don't see the numbers. They're still there, but you don't see them. I'm just going to put it back on so we can actually see them. You'll see then it specifies how do we know what the minimum is and what the maximum is. Excel has decided to automatically guess that the minimum bar is automatic, but I can say, well, actually no, minimum must be the lowest value, for example, or a certain number, or a certain percent. So if I go to the lowest value, when I say okay, you'll see it changes slightly, and what it's decided is the lowest value it sees over here is going to be the very smallest. If I go here and I choose that the maximum is the highest value, when I say OK and apply, this one here fills the entire bar. This may not be what you want though, so maybe you want to specify that a certain percent must be the highest value and a certain percent must be the lowest value. This is a bit confusing in Excel, so we're going to explain that just now. So that's that one there. If I come down here, highlight these, manage rules, edit, you'll see this is slightly different. So now what it's saying is, what is your style? Is it a two color or three color scale? Notice you can decide yourself how the color should work. So you can choose any color, through any color, to any color. And again, you can decide how does it determine the minimum color. So what's going to turn this green? Is it the lowest value, a number, percent, etc.? The midpoint, so at the moment it's saying look at the middle of these two, that'll be the yellow. But you may want to specify a certain number. So if I say the number is the midpoint, and let's say I decide that this bright yellow must be, let's choose that number there, 9347, highest value, that's fine. When I say okay, just watch what happens to that. You'll see it now adjusts this color scheme so that this is yellow. The best way, however, to understand all of this is actually with the icons. So let's just start with the risk rating. So firstly, you can see this is going the wrong way. The lowest number should be green. So firstly, I'm going to go and highlight it, manage rules, edit. So what you'll see now, again, you can specify the icon. What are you using? An icon set. Notice there is a reverse icon order. So notice it goes green, yellow, red. When I click reverse, now it's going red, yellow, green. So if I said OK and applied it, so that's already a lot better. It's reversed it. Then you'll see it tries to explain to you it's going to turn red when the value is bigger than or equal to 67%. Now you've got to be a little bit careful here. This word percent is not the same as that there, the percent there. This is actually more percentile. So you'll see it saying it must turn red when the value is bigger than or equal to 67%. This effectively is looking at the smallest number, the biggest number, working out the difference between the two, and then the top 67% of it will turn red. If we decide, for example, that there's a set number, so we've decided that only when it's above 90% do we want it to turn red. The way we tell Excel that is we're going to say turn red when the value is bigger than or equal to. I'm going to change this percent to rather say number, and I'm going to type my percentage in there, because remember percent is actually just a number, 0.90. I'm then going to say I want it to be yellow, so let's be extreme and say anything from that 90% all the way down to 10%. So I'm going to say, again, I need to change that to number. So it must be yellow when it's less than 0.9. Notice it automatically put it in. And bigger than or equal to 10. Just make sure that's a number. Oh, sorry. So you'll see that it had automatically then adjusted its calculation so that it'll be red when it's bigger than 90%, yellow when it's less than whatever the red one is, but bigger than 10%, and green when it's less than 10%. So there's no gaps here. When I say OK and apply, you'll see now I've controlled how that works. Same thing with project completion. Excel has guessed, so you'll see that 39% is showing as not really done at all, which doesn't make sense to me, and this is because by default Excel uses this percentage, and in its terminology 39% is the smallest number, 95% is the biggest number, so that's finished, that's not finished, it's not even started, and then these are adjustments of it. But what I would say is perhaps we want to link it, so there's five items, so let's do it in gaps of 20%. So I'm going to say that must be a number, 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 number. So it's going to be 0.8, 0.6, 0.4, 0.2. When I say OK and apply it, so this now makes more sense to me. That's just a quarter done, that's basically finished, that's a half done, etc. So with all the conditional formatting, you're able to edit it, and for the most part, it's fairly logical over here.